Oh, yes. The time has arrived once again. Oh, spooky, spooky. It's already spooky. As long as you can remember, legends have been told about the derelict mansion upon the hill that casts a blanket of darkness over the town. You know what that feels like? It feels like Castlevania. This comes with... I'll eventually get the DLC, which I hear is really good, but it hasn't been ported over to the new engine yet. Ah, shit! Too spook for this dupe.
And this is my home. Can you, Humble Flare, make it through 1,000 rooms? Can you find what lies at the end? Or is there even an end?
Is it?
I don't really know.
Is the treasure at the end going to be friendship? If the treasure at the end is friendship, I'm not even gonna fucking play it. So yeah, I remember playing an incomplete version of this, the free version, way back in the day and really liking it. I went into this wanting to like this a lot. A lot of it has certainly been improved. It's running on Unity now instead of the Game Maker 8 engine, which is a big jump. However, the port did not go smoothly. Basic infrastructural stuff like the menus don't work in VR. I understand VR was not the main focus of this port, but there's some stuff that there's really no excuse for. Like, I couldn't adjust the... There was an option to adjust my thumbstick sensitivity in the menu, but it didn't work. Like, it's there and it works if you play a non-VR mode, which is how I finally fixed the controls. But if you go in VR to that part of the menu, you just can't adjust the sensitivity. And it doesn't let you use your touch controllers either. I had to use the gamepad, which is a problem. Because the newest, Windows 10 anniversary update breaks support for their own fucking gamepads. To where it works... With a fresh boot of the PC, your controller will sync with the wireless adapter, but then if you ever turn it off after that, it won't. It'll turn... You'll turn your controller on, and 2 seconds later, it turns itself off. And the only way to fix that, temporarily, is to reboot your computer. So I really did not want to have to use my gamepad for this. How I'm using it is plugged in via USB, which is the only way I could find to make it work. Which would not have been a problem. That's not the developer's fault, of course. It just wouldn't have been a problem if they supported tracked motion controllers. They didn't have to actually put my hands in the game. Just let me use them as an alternative to the gamepad, please. A lot of basic stuff in this game does not work. And a lot of it's specific to the VR mode, which is irritating. I didn't get a refund because it works well enough. But I'm not happy with this. I may redo the review if they fix all the issues. Oh yeah, 3D models. That's the other thing. They have 3D models in this now. Whereas before, there were only sprites. Which was kind of charming. I like sprites. That's one of the things I liked about the game, but I guess I'm indifferent. It doesn't matter to me that much that they switched the monsters, some of them, to... 3D models. I'm glad they didn't change Spooky. If they had made Spooky 3D, I would have rage quit. Oh, this is tight music, too. I love the music in this game. This is such a comfy game. I'm so fucking cozy right now. I'm just a little cozy bro. Wrapped up in my blanket playing this nice pixelated cute horror game. Are you cozy? I hope you're cozy. If you're not, go wrap yourself up in a blanket and get yourself some cocoa, because this is going to be a motherfucking cozy playthrough. Ah! Oh, shit! No! No! Ah! How you gonna do me like that? You cute little tree stump. Oh no. Uh-oh. That's rarely a good sign. Human remains. Can I pick you up? No, I can't. Another skull. Why are these not 3D? It's inconsistent. Either do all sprites or do all models. Game Maker 8, which is just fucking Flintstones technology for making a 3D game, couldn't do 3D models. It was like Wolfenstein 3D levels of complexity. But that's charming. I like that. It makes me nostalgic for those old 2.5D shooters, which mixed those pseudo 3D environments with sprites. I like sprites. I like pixel art. And this is kind of the best of both worlds. I get pixel art in my 3D space. It's like how a 2D game converted to 3D should look. I wonder how a game like that would do these days, if you made a new ego shooter. Not literally Duke Nukem 3D, but a game like that, like Shadow Warrior and Blood and Redneck Rampage, with a whole new character, but you made it on a modern engine that was designed to just imitate the restrictions of, like, the Doom or Build engine. But it still had, like, all the sassy one-liners and shit, and interactivity. I think that would do pretty well. Like, the people who would find that nostalgic are now old enough to be the ones with a lot of discretionary income for buying games, so I feel like indie games that are trying to be retro have graduated from imitation 8-bit up to imitation 16-bit, and now we're going to start to see some early 3D as retro. I hope so. That would be pretty cool. What are these? What are these fucking handrails? It's like the lines at Disneyland. Ah, no! I'm not actually that scared. I'm not scared. You're too fucking cute, you spoopy Skeleman. First Skeleman of the game. That's a milestone. Probably many more spelling prompts to come. If you're expecting there to be more to this game, there is, but really it is just about endurance, which I kind of like. I like the mindless grind of one room after the other. And it doesn't matter what fucking order you go through them in either. Like, there's not different rooms at the end of either of these doors. I just have to get through 1,000 of them. More of this weird handrail shit. Oh no. Oh no, I'm spooked. I don't know about this, Scoob. Watch me swoosh right in! I was the last person on Earth to find out about Skooks on YouTube poop, and I'm a little bit butthurt about that still. Am I just getting old? Am I gonna be behind the times on the dankest new memes? Probably they're called something different now. They're not even dank memes now, I bet. Oh no! I'm scared! Is that Lumpy Space Princess? I think that is. It looks like LSP. Oh my gosh! That reminds me, when are we gonna get a new Adventure Time game? The fucking... Fucking Magic Man's head games was enchanting as shit on Gear VR. It was really, it was criminally short. I can't believe I spent. It was, I guess it was $5, so I can't be too angry. It was only really two levels, although there were several sections per level. But it was really cool, and I'm a whore for 3D platformers. I grew up during that whole, like, I reached the age where I was actually conscious about games enough to enjoy them and develop taste during the era of copy and paste, you know, Nintendo 64 3D platformers where everybody was making one. So I love those. I'll play anything along those lines. Ukulele has got me really excited. Because I loved Banjo-Kazooie. I loved Banjo-Tooie. I loved Mario 64. Conker's Bad Fur Day, Tonic Trouble, Rocket Robot on Wheels, Buck Bumble, even fucking Buck Bumble. It almost can't be too, you know, down market for me to play it. I'll still play it. If it's a 3D platformer with bright colors and catchy music, I'll play it. I'll play the fuck out of it. Oh no! Another terrifying monster! You cannot disrupt my comfort. I'm the comfiest bro ever to fucking get comfy. Look at all these fucking cozy ass beds too. What kind of scary mansion is this? This is like the mansion of cozy dreams where you just listen to the rain outside. Maybe listen to music or read a book in one of these cozy beds. I'm not scared. I probably will be. I don't remember a lot about this game. I just remember that there are fucked up things that happen later on. Like, it stops being cute pretty quickly, and then horrible thing. And it's not even just, like, basic monster maze shit like you'd find on Game Jolt. There's a story, if you can believe it. Like, you can read computer monitors and shit about, like, entries about how they were experimenting on different creatures and some of them got loose. So there's more to. Yeah, see? There's notes. Which I guess there have to be, because if this was really all there was to the game. Asking people to go through 1,000 rooms of it would be a bit much. That dude brought it on himself, really. Why would you go dungeon crawling and not even bring water? You're just gonna wind up drinking your own pee. Is this the fucking... Yeah, this is the church elevator. The church slash elevator. Like the ones that exist in every community, I assume. What the fuck? This better not be permanent. Good. Steam VR has issues with calculating height. I've had that happen before. Where's the charming music? Bring the music back. Push out the noise, bring in the funk. And the love. What is that? How do you get up there? Is that... Do naughty boys sit there when they're in the fucking detention corner? So far I really like the aesthetic. Oh, what? I don't remember this. Do these work? If these work, I'm gonna... Fucking shut the front door. Do these work? They fucking work! Oh my god! I have never been so fucking hardcore enchanted in my life! Oh, wait a minute. I'm the fucking ghost. This is the best thing I've ever seen. I'm so hard. I'm so gay for this game. Officially, I'm hard gay for this game. I can't fucking believe that the arcade machines work. All is forgiven. All the janky ass shit that prevented me from getting in this game is forgiven. Did that dude's head explode? That dude's head exploded. Why do I have to keep that meter filled up? Is my knife thirsty for blood? As knives tend to become? This is fucking amazing. A lot of shit has been added since I last played this. I'm glad that I took a break from it. It's a game within a game, within a Walmart, within a Starbucks, within a Taco Bell, within another simulation. This is like shit that we were playing on Newgrounds in 2002. Flash games didn't really go away, did they? They just live on our phones now. Am I too good at this? Am I too skilled at video games and too handsome? Apparently not. No way! I don't remember any of this. This has to be new. I also am glad that it's been so long. I quit this game originally because at room 500 or so, there was some kind of glitch and I fell out of the level and it kept breaking every time I loaded my save game and I just didn't want to start over. So I rage quit and I'm glad I did. Because I allowed, not on purpose, but I allowed enough time to pass that a lot of new shit was added. What's happening? What is this fucking shit? I have to hold up to go. What is that? Why can't I hold the A button? Oh, I love that the cars are sprites. Are those weird British three-wheeled cars, the Reliant Robin? I think so. I believe so, yeah. That's one of those three wheel. No! I'm sorry, tree! No! Captain Planet's gonna come to fucking kick my ass now. I'm so fucking impressed. My coziness has increased tenfold. Tenfold. I'm getting kind of mixed messages from this game. Like, it starts out cute, and then it starts to get a little bit creepy, but then it starts to get, like, silly again. I don't know how to feel. What else is new, right? What? What am I? Did my car get bigger, or am I flying? You know what? I don't care. I'm okay with it. I'm flying now, I guess. That's normal. I'm really invested in this. See, this is the kind of shit that they could not have even possibly done with Game Maker. Game Maker is just Babby's first video game making suite. It's like RPG Maker 2000. You can basically do anything in Unity, though. So was I unable to get more time because my car was floating? I don't know, man. Fucking video game mysteries. And it's creepy again. This is reminding me of fucking Rise of the Triad. All 10 people watching this who played that will know what I mean. Because it had, a cup of coffee? That's not even scary, that's refreshing. I could go for some coffee right now. And I would drink it out of a cup with a face on it that was alive, even if the cup screamed at me to stop drinking its brains. That would actually increase my enjoyment. Maybe in the future, maybe we'll have, like, Starbucks cups with faces on them. Tell you not to drink them. Uh-oh. Probably not good. Oh, shit! Oh, shit! Fuck my stupid asshole! No! That escalated quickly. Where are my happy, fun video games? Where's Spooky Cart? Not now, ice cream cone. Now's not the fucking time. These are all the splotches where the dudes who got chased before me shit their fucking pants. I feel sure of it. From having seen a lot of shit stains in my time. At Disney World. No! Does this ever end? Can I ever get away? He can't come up out of these. Oh shit! He can't come up out of these, can he? Has he lost me? I think he lost me. Maybe that was like a special ed monster, who's easily confused. Pumpkin! You rapscallion. But yeah, Renzo the Triad had that thing going on where it can only do 90 degree corners, and levels could have, like, the ceiling be at any height you wanted, but the ceiling had to be the same height everywhere. And it could be sky, it could be like a parallax sky texture, but then you couldn't have any sort of ceiling unless it was made out of sprites. Like, the way they did stairs in that game was to have floating discs that were like little flying saucer things you stepped on. And that was just because they couldn't make steps out of... That's legit scary. Don't you fucking put that in my face. You're not invited to my Christmas party now. They couldn't do sector-based steps like the Doom Engine, so they had to make... If they wanted elevation changes, they had to do it with sprites. And let the player step onto sprite objects that looked like they were platforms. And I remember, if you were below them, it would change to a different sprite that had the correct perspective. So it looked like you were actually looking at it from underneath. But if you were on top or above, It had like a couple different views for that sprite, so it would look correct. It would look like you're actually looking down on it. And that was a neat workaround for such a basic engine. It had like, it did a lot. It did the most you could possibly do with such a rudimentary engine. There were rooms that could fill up with poisonous gas and you had to find a gas mask. There were bounce pads before Quake 3 had them. There was a bunch of different animated door types. They had rolling boulders that would go like Indiana. Oh shit! Oh shit! Rape face McGillicuddy is back! And they don't call him that for fucking fun. No! They call him that because he'll fucking rape your face! Why is my health full? I think I can go up here. Oh shit! No! 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 Nope! Nope! Same room as before. Thank goodness for small. They could have at least had this randomly generate pathways. It doesn't seem like it would have been impossible, because you will want to do more than one room like this, I think, in the course of the game. Oh, shit! Oh, I hate being touched! The less said about that, the better. Oh, I have regen health. That's kind of shitty. That takes away the tension. It should make me wait until I get to the elevator church to replenish my health. Here we go. That would have been a better way to do it, I think. Or at least have it regenerate much more slowly. This is the kind of church you went to, right? I wasn't the only one. Oh, and once again, I'm 11 feet tall. Well done, devs. Well, good show. Ooh, new textures. This also reminds me of Aliens vs. Predator on Jaguar. Just because of those piles of, like, acid that slow you down. There were parts where you'd kill an alien, and you'd have to walk through the acid in order to go forward, but it would hurt you and slow you down. And you'd have to use computers like this. This is actually reminding me a lot of AVP. Oh, it's Slime Princess. There's a lot of adventure. That's what she did for work after. Because she doesn't make a lot of appearances in episodes. There's fucking Rape Face McGillicuddy. I know what your deal is. Everybody knows what your deal is. When your name is Rape Face, there's really no question what you're about. I like that little cute face, though. He doesn't want to be here. He's sorry you have to go through all this. Oh fuck, what the fuck is that thing? I don't want to meet that thing. That's one dad I don't want to meet. Don't want to meet that dad. Do-do-do-do. Can I romance the ghosts? Probably not. This thing could probably fucking run Doom 4 really well, though. That'd be cool if I, like, use this terminal and it plays, starts playing a copy of the game that I'm already in. Kind of, I guess. It would be mildly amusing for about a minute. I don't know if you heard on the microphone, but, like, a terror fart escaped my colon. Just a little one, like a squeaker. Consider that an endorsement. Cute spider. Don't have time for your hijinks. I'm really sick, man. I should be paying attention to my biological needs instead of running away from my problems in VR. But there's so many rooms left to go. Am I underground now? Is that what happened? How big is this fucking house? Spooky must have been loaded. I would rate Spooky as one of the top three ghost waifus. On the same level as or slightly below that cute ghost girl from Sonic the Werehog, the only good part of that game. If you remember her, she was the flavor of the month on V for a while. Delicious toast. I would be unhappy too if I were a food item. I could dip you in the fucking living coffee from earlier. I want to recommend this because I'm having fun now, finally. It was just a huge fucking hassle to set this up. I expect more. I see why this is not on Oculus Home. Uh-oh. I'm in that room from Alien Resurrection. Or fucking Raptor, come on! Come on. It's Jurassic Park 2. You can't have both. Uh-oh. Oh, so Spooky has employees, apparently. That sounds like Spooky. Generic lab assistant. Well, if that's your name, then you already know you're gonna fucking die before the game is over. Raptors, come on. Come on, guys. Oh, I don't like it. Clicking. It's the fucking centipede, isn't it? Centipedes in my video game? It's more likely than you think. These holes are not. Oh, bad news bears, bad news bears, bad news bears. No, no. Nope! Nope! Norley! Ah, shit! Ah! Why you do this to me? It's like a combination fucking spider centipede. It's a centipede. Oh, my dick is tingling, and not in the fun way. Oh, I think I remember this. I think there's a whole different monster. Like right after I escaped from one fucking thing, there's another fucking thing that comes after me. Oh, I get it.
Hello? Yes. Hello, hello? I don't know if you want to look directly into the fan. Yes, hello. Hello?
Hello.
Hello, hello,
Had enough of your shit. I think this was a reference to Five Nights at Freddy's. I think. That's my take on it. Yeah, I want to tell you to go pick this up because I'm finally having fun, but it was such a fucking huge headache to get this working. I had to start the game. I had to, when audio was not coming out of the Rift headphones, I had to close the end of the game, but the game was still running. I couldn't relaunch it because it said a copy of the game was still running. So I had to close out of Steam to stop that from running because I couldn't find it in the task list. Then when I got into it, and the audio was coming out of the headphones like I wanted, except that then I had the problem of being unable to adjust the sensitivity for the thumbsticks, which was way too high. So I had to close out of it again, and I couldn't just relaunch it. I once again had to close out of Steam entirely. It was just a fucking janky mess, which... LSP, you're fucking everywhere these days. Probably she didn't let me see her running from that last room to this one because she doesn't like people to see her sweat. I wonder if that's because the person who made this game is an Adventure Time fan, or if Adventure Time just uses such generic, cute blob characters, that if you try to make a cute blob character, almost guaranteed it will have shown up in some Adventure Time episode. I don't know. Having the menu stuff up here also kind of sucks, and also becoming 11 feet tall suddenly. It's sucky. If you give us touch controls, you can put all that stuff on a wristwatch or something. Think about that, why don't you? Even though this is such a fucking goofy, cute-looking game, I don't want to die. I really do not want to die in this game. Oh, alright. Yeah, having this game, this room rearrange itself would be nice. That doesn't seem like it'd be hard since these are all cubic sections. You just have it shuffle them around and then check to ensure that at least one of them leads to the exit. That would add a lot of tension during monster chases. I also looked up the ending to this once, but I don't remember it. And I'm really glad. That's really comforting. I'm inside of Gay Tetris. I always knew it in my heart somehow. Oh, fuck. Not high school. Come on. There's a limit to sadism. More high school. Just what I wanted! Probably now Spooky is gonna show up with a bunch of other popular ghost girls and laugh at me and call me a faggot. If my memories serve me correctly. I guess they had to do this though, because high schools are like a cliche ghost story setting, at least in fucking Japanese ghost movies, which I've watched way too many of. Why do I like this? I've often asked myself. Why do I like to scare myself? Someone pointed out to me that... Oh, no! No! This is not acting. I really do not want to be captured. Girls actually did chase me in middle school, too. And I thought maybe if you let them catch you, sexy times happen. Sexy times don't happen. They take your pants off and then you have to fucking walk to the office in your Star Trek tidy whities. Not right now, spelling pomp. And wait for your mom to bring you more new pants. Let that be a lesson to you. Why does this music make it worse? It's so much worse. This is so simple, but it's still scary. I think that's the point of it. It's like a parody of how every scary game, scary indie game, is just a monster maze. Some kind of creature chasing you. So they boiled it down to the simplest possible graphics, but it's still fucking scary. I'm not ashamed of- oh, it's the centipede again. Centipedes in my vagina. It's more likely than you think. Not right now, coffee! I want you later, though. After this. But yeah, somebody pointed out that every form of entertainment that I enjoy is some kind of self-punishment. Like, even really fun games I play are all focused around really demanding speed and precision, like arena shooters. I'm like one of the 10 people who still plays arena shooters religiously. And I'm mostly an instagib or railgun guy, so that's like how to play the game in no fun allowed mode. I play Thumper a lot, which is really just getting punched in the face over and over until you like it. And I play horror games, which are fucking terrible for my nerves, and yet I love them. I must really not like myself or something. I'm having some kind of fun, though. I don't know if I would call it traditional fun. From a young age, some part of my brain has been short-circuited to where things that should frighten a healthy person are just exciting to me. And I don't mean like I'm some kind of badass, like I'm Batman. I mean like I had to be kept away from cars and trains because I'd run at them and be like, oh, you know, it's a big, loud, exciting, fast-moving thing with lights on it. I have to get closer to that. That thing's fucking awesome. And I didn't register. Some part of my brain didn't register. Oh, good, Silent Hill. Didn't register that I was in danger and should be afraid of whatever that thing was. And that has followed me into adulthood. I still enjoy things that should scare me, just make me feel exhilarated. It forces me to take the game seriously for however long the scary part lasts. Which is, I think, a trick a lot of developers lean on, and why there was such a surge in indie horror games in particular. Because the game doesn't have to be very good to be immersive if it's scary. People don't want to be frightened, so they pay close attention to the game in order to avoid the fucking terrifying monster from capturing them. When you combine that effect with virtual reality, which is another sort of cheap tactic to force immersion, the effect compounds on itself, if you know what I mean. You have two, because developers lean on VR a lot too to force immersion and make a game more compelling, which otherwise would not have been. You know, really mediocre games that would not be fun to play on a monitor become... Oh no! Well, that's one of the new 3D ones too. Oh, terrifying polygon. Oh, we can bust down doors. Fuck my ass. Don't actually fuck my ass until we've gotten to know each other. I'm not that kind of girl. But yeah, I think the other half of it was that I discovered slasher movies at a formative stage in my life. Fucking Facebones. Spoopy McFacebones here. Ah, shit! Ah, why did I slow down? There's music! Oh, no! Not my pooper! No, I went the wrong way, didn't I? No, wait, this rearranged itself. I thought it couldn't do that. Can it float? It can't float, can it? It can float! It can float! That's bullshit! Ah! How come it can float, but I have to walk on this circuitous-ass wallway? Walkway. I can't think. All my blood has gone from my brain into my clenched asshole and fully engorged fear boner. Speaking of fear boners, keep your kids away from slasher flicks when they're going through puberty, for God's sake. Because that had such a profound influence on what I find arousing.
So, you made it this far. That's great. I shall grant you a gift for your progress.
How about a blowjob? Ghost blowjob! Woo woo! Oh, badass picture. Fuck you. That's all. Oh, I see. You scamp! Anyway, yeah. I think you know what I'm talking about. There's, like, every director who made slasher flicks had the same sexual hang-ups, I think. Like, the tropes everybody knows about, like the virgin is the only one who survives and whoever has sex dies first. And just gratuitous scenes of women in thin tank tops and panties scampering away from the killer, just jiggling all over the place. That's going to create a lot of unhealthy associations between sexuality and violence and fear in the minds of adolescent young males, and it's just gonna make them into the same kinds of fucking freaks who direct these movies in the first place. That's my PSA. That's my warning PSA. If you have a teenage son, maybe keep Friday the 13th movies away from him until he's at least 20. I mean, I'm not saying I take dates to abandoned buildings and then chase them around dressed in a monster costume with my boner hanging out. I'm not saying that. That would be really messed up. But I'm also not saying it. And you would think that being chased by a monster with his dick hanging out would just be funny, not scary. But no, it's still scary. It's still scary. But isn't the monster all of us in the end? Or are we the boner? These are the questions we have to ask ourselves. Was there a scamp? There was a scamp. You adorable little fellow. Something to date my own romantic. This guy says romantic a lot. Red wine. I'm not sure what brand or year. Metallic. He drank liquefied death metal is the problem here. Oh, that's the fucking rape music. Do I need to cover my butthole? There's never a good time to uncover your butthole, is there? Not in this game. Oh no. Oh, this rape train has no brakes! Oh, chugga 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 choo choo! Here comes the rape train! No! 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 Don't you nibble my fucking tender hams! These tender Christmas hams are not for centipedes to nibble on. Unless you were to, like, slap some boobs on there, then it could be a potential waifu for guys who are into monster. Almost anything could be a waifu. If you put tits and neon hair on, like, a 5-gallon bucket or a cinder block, Presto, that's an exciting new waifu that will be considered by some men of dubious taste. Cinderblock Chan probably already exists somewhere. This is really delivering on the nostalgic retro feels and the butthole clenching terror feels, and I really like almost everything about it, except that the port to VR was apparently handled by a room full of starving chimpanzees. You can't just do quick and dirty VR ports, it's going to destroy your credibility. Don't put anything out there with your name on it if it isn't great. I know that's easy to say, but I've never done it. I mean, I haven't made games, though. I've written and published a lot, and I've never put out anything with my name on it that I didn't believe in the quality of. This game should legit come with a diaper. Not for like weird fetish reasons, not for like weird deviant art fetish reasons, but just to catch you. When you start blasting terror turds, you need something to collect all of it. You don't want that getting all over your nice computer chair. My reactor has not lost containment yet, if you know what I mean. I've had some close calls. Only by training my butthole on the top of Mount Hutsubatsutatsu with the Dragon Eagle Clan have I been able to hold in these terror turds. This is so cool. This sprite art is freaking cool. It looks like a 3D Sega Genesis game. I really want touch integration though. Just to be able to see my hands and to be able to play this without having to have the controller plugged in. What is this, like a Smurf sperm? That's what I'm looking at here, isn't it? Like a water droplet. Static means rape monster. Doesn't it? This is such a surprise. Blah 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 blah. Burr, 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 burr. Herp, derp, derp, derp. Your influence and inspiration will never leave me. Okay. You know, I'd probably be in worse trouble if you did have to romance some of the lady monsters. Uh-oh. This room repeats itself, doesn't it? This room repeats itself. What if I go backwards? That's not good. This is not... I'm getting PT vibes here. There's some kind of secret wall, isn't there? Oomph! Oomph! Where is it? I'm running into walls now! Let's see. Clues. What I could admire. Another actual entry. What does that mean? An entry to this room? What does this fucking clue mean? What does this clue mean? Oh! Suddenly I can go through here for no reason. That's really satisfying. Good puzzle. Good job with that puzzle, guys. Oh, this isn't good. Is this a fucking... This is a fucking Zelda dungeon, isn't it? This is the fucking Eye of Truth? I can't believe this. Nothing's sacred. Alright, wait a minute. I do something with the torches, don't I? What if I go back through here? I can't. Huh. Huh. Okay. Okay, all of a sudden. Yeah, this is fucking Zelda. This is from Majora's Mask. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna be chased by that creepy rape face elf. You remember that guy who sells the puppets? This is like a combination of the Eye of Truth dungeon and Puppet McRapeface from Zelda. I'm actually a little bit angry at how bullshit this is. Very creative, though. They parody a lot of different things. This is the first room, isn't it? Okay, that one's... Can I go through here? I can't. I can't go through there. I'm confused. I'm confused. This is the first room. I thought I... There's some kind of warp fuckery going on here. Was there a key? There was a key I overlooked, I bet. There's a key somewhere. I already saw that. Here we go. Yeah, I'm stupid. Which comes as a surprise to nobody. I need a boss key, don't I? Yes, I do. I'm digging this, man. There's a lot more story to this than you would expect there to be. And arguably more than there needs to be, but I like that. It never becomes overbearing. There's always long breaks between rooms that have readable pages in them. So it's not like a, not like Call of Cthulhu or something where I'm sitting here. Uh-oh. Oh, fuck. That was stupid. Nope. Don't you touch my butthole. Stranger danger. No, he's gonna kill me. No, coffee. How could you betray me in my darkest hour? I don't want to die, I don't want to die, I don't want to die. Not like this, man. Oh, you have to look at him. If you look at him, you can't move. Ah, what the fuck? How can he slap? Ah, that's fucking bullshit. Oh, no, no, no! Right in my tendies. Oh, no, I'm dead. No, don't go into the light. Don't go into the light. I don't care how many twerking angels you see. Nothing good is in there. Oh no, optometry! A fate worse than death. That was pretty cool. I'm pretty satisfied. There's a lot the developer needs to fix for the VR adaptation, but so far I'm liking what I see, and given that there's a lot of free shit on the way, like Karamari Hospital DLC, I may have been too hard on him, or her, or them. I guess I'll wait and see. That's all for this time, though. Stay cozy.